My first decree as the president of the man bird, the emperor of the country.
Well, but surely not. Will.
Is to revoke the citizenship of Wilbur Soot and Tommy in it.
The Lamanburg election arc, a saga of ambition and power struggles, written mainly by one man, Wilbur Soot. But of course, to write a story of political intrigue, one must be knowledgeable on politics itself, and Wilbur has very much hinted at his expertise with the matter on stream.
But remember that. Rule number 11, respect authority, but only if they're not challenging your rights. Otherwise, brick a windshield.
But what if I told you that the politics of Wilbur the president, that the positions taken by the Pog Party were the exact opposite of what Wilbur Soot the content creator believes? That's right, today we'll be doing a deep dive into the politics of each candidate in the Lamanburg presidential election, something which occurred 6 months ago. We'll be covering this extremely timely topic with a trusty political compass which is centered on two axes, the economic from left to right, and social from authoritarian to libertarian, to provide reference to real-life figures. So, no matter which party you voted for in the election, stick around, I'm sure it'll be worth your while. Though, if you supported Wilbur and Tommy, you won't be able to look at them the same way after this. Speaking of which, let's begin with the political organization that began this whole mess, Wilbur Soot's Pog Party. Now, despite one of their party members, Tommy Innit, being the so-called protagonist of the story arc, they are not the good guys, not by a long shot. First off, the creator of the party, Wilbur Soot, ran as a nativist, espousing nationalist rhetoric to the point where he questioned if the swag party were traitors to Lamanburg because their nominee for vice president, George Not Found, was a member of Lamanburg's arch nemesis, the Dream SMP. His bigotry wasn't limited to George either. Throughout the debate, Wilbur had angry outbursts about the Americans.
I'm running this election to solidify democracy in our great nation of Lamanburg, and if you vote for me, I'll keep those filthy Americans.
He fucked up
and portrayed the people outside of Lamanburg as a threat to their hard-earned way of life, drawing on the us versus them ideology that is populism. Now, populism is essentially an ideology which presents the people as a morally good force and contrasts them against an elite class, who are portrayed as corrupt and a traitor to their country. Populists can usually differ in how the people are defined, but they can be based along class or national lines. For the Pog Party, they went with national lines to augment their populist rhetoric, thus making Wilbur a right-wing populist. The nationalism of the party is evident, with Wilbur proposing the continuation of the harsh border policies set by his administration, as well as pushing back against Quackity's proposal to destroy the border wall, which, in Wilbur's view, was the only thing keeping the Dream SMP away from infiltrating the young nation and taking its hard-won independence. But nationalism and the Dream SMP weren't the entire agenda of the Pog Party. They called for policies to help their citizens, like lower taxes and the creation of a very, very heavily armed version of PETA, which would keep the peace and crack down on criminals who threatened the livelihoods of their beloved pets, like Sapnap. With all of that in mind, it's important to remember the tyrannical origins of the Pog Party. Let's not forget that this entire election was called because people were disobeying Wilbur's authority, and he wanted to return to his previous prestige, where people would follow his orders to the letter. Thus, Wilbur can be placed on the authoritarian right quadrant of the political compass. In fact, we know exactly where he is in that quarter, because candidate Wilbur Soot is Donald Trump. Now, before you come for me, think about it. Both of them were nationalist, nativist, and right-wing populist on the campaign trail. Wilbur and the former president both had a tough on crime message and a promise to militarize the police force.
If I am re-elected as president, I would like to create a police force that will uphold the law so that no further pets are killed in Lemanburg.
I am the law and order candidate.
Trump and Wilbur both railed against foreign immigrants and thought they were a threat to the very existence of their country.
When Mexico sends its people, they're not sending their best. They're bringing drugs, they're bringing crime, they're rapists.
What you are intending to do is come into our land and open it up to the very people we seek to escape.
There's a case to be made that Tommy in it is basically a Mike Pence kinnie, considering how much of a Twitch Prime cultist he was back in September. Hell, a major focal point of both their elections was on a border war. Still not convinced? Roll the tape!
Okay, Tommy, when I said I'm running them as a third party, I didn't actually put them on the ballot.
Well, but you can't not let it's a democracy.
Oh my god! What's the idea?
There's only one woman on this server, and she's an American, so there's no way we're letting her into our new
state. But Europe stays winning! For years, nay I say decades, the Dream SMP has ostracized my group of people, my European brethren stood behind me. Lemanburg is not a place of oppression, it is a place of sanctuary for our people. What you are intending to do is come into our land and open it up to the very people we seek to escape, just because we've created a better life for ourselves. This in itself is tyranny and I will not stand for it.
America was founded on liberty and independence.
We'll grow from war. Of course, you're a warmonger.
Of course they had to grow from war. We were oppressed.
You love to have war.
We were an oppressed people, Quackity. What? I led these people to freedom. And I will keep and uphold the policies. Yeah. I will uphold the policies with freedom. Lemanburg's borders, as long as I'm in charge, will stay closed to all who are non-European.
Tonight, we renew our resolve that America will never be a socialist country.
The Park Party was essentially the textbook right-wing populist party, displaying their traditional policies of anti-immigration, protectionism, and authoritarianism perfectly. After all, this entire election was called just so that Wilbur could gain more political power. It's just that it all went so wrong because of a certain Mexican lawyer and his British running mate. But before we continue, a quick reminder that, hey, if you somehow got past the part of me comparing the internet's favorite e-boy to one of the most unpopular presidents in modern history, I think you'll like the rest of my content. This is my first ever video, so statistically speaking, I have absolutely no idea how many of you are subscribed right now, but please just check if you're subscribed, and if you aren't, hit that red button and slap that bell like it's, I don't know, your arch enemy's face. Yeah, just go do that. It wouldn't mean the absolute world to me, seriously. Anyways, on with the rest of the video. The Swag Party was the main competitor against the Park Party, nominating Quackity and George to go head-to-head with Wilbur and Tommy. They were practically polar opposites on the campaign and were constantly at loggerheads, with Quackity calling Wilbur a dictator and Wilbur insinuating that Quackity was colluding with enemy forces to be a backstabbing traitor. The first clash during the debates was over immigration. Quackity wanted to open up the borders of Lemanburg so that everybody could see the beauty of their nation, while Wilbur was busy melting down over traitors at every possible corner. With the two members of the Swag Party not being original Lemanburgians like Tubbo and Tommy, Quackity experienced racism against him firsthand. Thus, he proposed civic education programs to encourage tolerance and stop the hate present under the Soot administration, which would hopefully end incidents like Tommy bullying Fundy because he was a furry. It would have also served the purpose of easing tensions between the Dream SMP and the Lemanburg, so that stuff like the pet war and the war for independence wouldn't happen again. The liberalism of the Swag Party doesn't just end with their education policies. Quackity and George were quite dovish in their rhetoric on war and defense, which shouldn't be that surprising considering the fact that George was literally a citizen of the Dream SMP. The two painted Tommy and Wilbur as paranoid warmongers who were obsessed with conflict, while they themselves took more pacifist stances, despite the fact that George not found, you know, kind of violated the Geneva Convention a dozen times, but we don't talk about that. Last but not least, the swag party painted the election as hope and change, represented by their party, versus the forces of dictatorship and stasis led by the current administration. Quackity called Wilbur an autocrat and ran to promote a true democracy. So, with his policies of increased immigration, education, and general liberalism, who does Quackity resemble the most? Well, it's simple. Castro. No, not that one. I'm talking about Julian Castro, 2020 candidate for the Democratic presidential nomination, who ran a liberal campaign focusing on immigration and the border wall. He was center-left, in between Sanders and Biden, thus placing Quackity himself in the libertarian left quadrant as well. Now, onto the third parties. We begin with Coconut 2020, a party founded for the sole reason that anything happens at all in the Dream SMP. Tommy being a bitch boy as per usual. Now, I don't have much to say about them, but they did have one main policy, the delivery of cookies and ice cream to everybody on the server. That's seriously it. I checked. They had nothing else. Now, as Karl Marx famously said, and here famous Marxist economist Richard D. Wolff quotes,
"Socialism is when the government does stuff. And it's more socialism, the more stuff it does. And if it does a real lot of stuff, it's communism."
Thanks, Richard. Anyways, since if Fundy was elected, he would have been the president, aka the guy in the government who does stuff. That would mean he's left wing at least. So we can tell the two quadrants on the right hand side to piss off. While Fundy's bakery business does qualify us, and I quote, "a real lot of stuff," he didn't say that it would be directly run by the Manberg, so it isn't fully socialist either. In my opinion, Fundy's signature policy makes him the closest to Andrew Yang's universal basic income, with Warren and Saunders' Medicare for All proposals bearing some resemblance as well, which would put the Coconut 2020 ticket further down in the libertarian left quadrant compared to swag. Last, but definitely not least, is JSchlatt 2020. Now, for JSchlatt, we have to split him up into two versions. There's pre-election version JSchlatt and post-election version JSchlatt, and the two are as different as night and day. For his pre-election persona, however, we should begin with the story of what happened before he joined the SMP. In one of the latest episodes of Tales from the SMP, Schlatt, in his ghost form, implies that at least some of his backstory in SMP Live is carried over, as seen in this clip here.
Me and Connor are boys. We ran a business back in the day on a server that was, I don't know what the fuck happened to it.
Now, for those of you who are unaware, Schlatt's persona is that of a laissez-faire businessman who got up to antics like selling Schlatt coin, a made-up cryptocurrency, and forming Schlatt & Co., with Connor as his right-hand man. His focus on business and making a profit while flaunting the law puts him in the libertarian right quadrant. Post-election JSchlatt, however, is a different beast. As soon as he defeated Pog 2020 by under 1%, thanks to the coalition agreement with Swag 2020, he immediately proclaimed himself emperor and exiled Wilbur and Tommy. Now, as Quackity was part of his administration as vice president, thanks to their parties joining together, he did have to adopt some of their policies, mainly the tearing down of Lemanberg's walls. However, instead of following Quackity's dreams of letting all come in and witness Lemanberg's beauty, Schlatt had another purpose for the order.
"I reckon our nation needs to expand.
Is that so?
I reckon we've done our country a great disservice. I reckon we take down the walls."
As you can see from that, the self-proclaimed emperor had expansionist ambitions, not to mention how his condemnations of Tommy and Wilbur...
Until further notice, Wilbur Soot and Tommy Innit are merely a memory of the Manberg, a relic of the past, a reminder of the darkest era this country has ever seen, and I guarantee you all, dear citizens, tonight, that changes. We are entering into a new period of Manberg, a period of prosperity, of strength, of unity.
Drew on the fantasies of a national rejuvenation and avenging a dark past. With all of this in mind, I believe that post-election Schlatt presents a dramatic break from the unspoken rules that the Soot administration used to govern the Manberg, and posed a bigger threat towards the stability of the entire server than any other government or nation that has existed since. Schlatt, while no fascist, went even further than Wilbur's racism and anger towards the Dream SMP, as even Wilbur knew that they were outmatched in a fight. Schlatt, on the other hand, embraced ultranationalism, thus placing him even higher than Wilbur on the authoritarian right quadrant. In conclusion, the 2020 Le Manberg presidential election was an absolute mess and had candidates ranging from all across the political spectrum, with Wilbur Soot being a conservative populist as he despised immigrants with a passion and anybody who wasn't European in general, and he was determined to retain the traditions which he had used to govern Le Manberg since its birth, and was basically Trump-burr. He was a Trump-kinnie for the entire thing. Seriously, how did y'all not notice? Quackity, on the other hand, was a standard liberal who believed in progress, generational change, and a new era of peace and prosperity. Fundy went even further than Quackity, wanting to deliver cookies and ice cream to all as a sort of welfare program for the citizens of Le Manberg. Schlatt was the most insane out of all of them, having two political personas. His businessman one carried over from SMP Live and other projects, which mainly cared about making a profit and running a business, and his authoritarian presidential one, which surfaced after the election as Schlatt took more and more power in order to govern Le Manberg the best he could. But before we go, please do remember that these are all for laughs and shits and giggles, and are for the roleplay personas of these people, not their actual real life selves. I do not believe that Wilbur Soot is a raging racist in real life. This was all for fun and was an absolute blast to make. I'll leave the links to the various world downloads below along with my Twitch channel. Make sure to share this video if you somehow found this absolute dumpster fire of a video interesting to you. And tell me what you liked, what you didn't, so I can improve for the next one. And keep an eye out for my next video. Is Technoblade an anarchist? Featuring an interview with an actual anarchist. This has been Kadrin, over and out.